Harry's furious at Meghan after Trump-hating bishop embarrasses queen at wedding. The leftists are touting Bishop Michael Curry's sermon at the royal wedding as legendary. Don't be fooled, the over-the-top rambling rant was laden with shocking New Age teachings that are hardly Christian. In fact, it's pure evil. The Queen was mortified along with many royals as Curry's theme was straight from hell. Prince Harry was livid at Meghan, and what happened behind the scenes left her in tears. When we learn Meghan Markle had booked left-wing Bishop Curry as the main speaker for the royal wedding, we knew there would be problems. Besides being a total hater of President Donald Trump, Curry is a political hack, not a devout Orthodox Christian bishop. Michael Curry is the current presiding bishop and primate of the Episcopal Church in the United States. If you missed his royal wedding sermon, count yourself lucky. Those who were mesmerized by his overuse of the word love missed the real message, which was the anti-Christian heresies of the New Age religion. As Bishop Curry got on a roll, nothing was missed by the Queen, who is the official head of the Church of England, also known as the Anglican or Episcopal Church. Curry exclaimed, "He, Jesus, didn't sacrifice his life for himself, or anything he could get out of it. Jesus did not get an honorary doctorate for dying. He did it for others, for the other, for the good and well-being of others. That's love. For the well-being of others?" Anyone who watched Mel Gibson's The Passion of the Christ understands the horror of what Jesus endured on the cross to save our souls, due to our sins. Curry demeaning the crucifixion as some exercise for the well-being of others was the first sign that something was off. Then Curry goes on to give his true beliefs away when he tells the audience who his theology is based on, saying, "Pierre Teilhard de Chardin was at once a scientist, a Roman Catholic priest, a theologian, a true mystic. His was one of the great minds and spirits of the 20th century." What? Teilhard de Chardin went insane. His work was banned by the Catholic Church and all mainstream Protestant churches, as he didn't believe Christ saved anyone. He was an atheist who was one of the first New Agers believing in eugenics as the way the world must evolve to become this leftist paradise. Teilhard de Chardin wanted to engage in selective breeding of human beings to help evolution along. So far, we have allowed our race to develop at random. In the course of coming centuries, it is indispensable that a nobly human form of eugenics on a standard worthy on our personalities should be discovered and developed, wrote de Chardin in his book titled, The Phenomenon of Man. The reaction from the royal family members, including Prince Harry, was one of shock and disgust. Teilhard de Chardin was a fraud who hoaxed the world by reporting to find the missing link to prove Darwinism was 100% true and thus God didn't exist. Science magazine reports, in 1912, Piltdown Man turned out to be one of the most famous frauds in scientific history, a human cranium paired with an orangutan's jaw and teeth. Perpetrators included Pierre Teilhard de Chardin. Bishop Curry's mentor Teilhard de Chardin believed human beings will evolve to the Christ consciousness, which is exactly the same thing taught by occultists Madame Blavatsky and Alice Bailey. It's demonic. But since Bishop Curry shouted the word love over and over in his sermon, many people didn't understand what he was really teaching. But the Queen did, as did many in the audience. Prince Harry sat there somberly, at times with looks of disgust. Meghan Markle is too stupid to understand what went on. All she knows is that this is the religion of Hollywood, of Earth worship. This is also the origins of the global warming religion, of Gaia worship. Many people noticed at one point during Curry's tirade, Prince Charles' wife, Camilla Parker Bowles, leaned over and whispered something to Kate Middleton about the unorthodox New Age sermon. The Duchess of Cambridge thinks the sermon is out there too, giving a curt smile and a classic eye roll. Prince Harry tried to give a few smiles to ease the tension toward the end of Curry's rant, probably thanking God the long-winded sermon was coming to a close. Sir Elton John sat there with a frown the entire time, and the Queen's granddaughter, Zara Tyndall, daughter of Princess Anne, made headlines with her shocked reaction in the below tweet. Palace insiders said Harry was livid later on as he and Meghan got ready to head over to the first reception. It's not clear if he was just spouting off about Bishop Curry's over-the-top performance or if he was reacting to the real message, which was completely unorthodox and new age, but Meghan was said to be in tears. His cousins Princesses Eugenie and Beatrice found it so amusing, leaning over and looking at their father, the Queen's son Prince Andrew, for his reaction. Well, this is what happens when you marry a Hollywood leftist who books a New Age leftist hat to be the main speaker. Oprah, George Clooney, and his wife Amala loved Bishop Curry, as did Meghan's mom, Doria Ragland. They were all smiles, nodding yes as Curry explained how people are going to evolve the world into a new paradise. Meghan got all the Hollywood A-listers at the event, as her dad sat in his Mexican hellhole watching her don the brightest hue of virginal white wedding dress on TV. No ivory or off-white for Meghan. She was making a bold feminist statement. One thing is for sure, as long as the Queen is alive, the new Duchess of Sussex won't ever be left to plan another Windsor event. This royal wedding was a hot mess from start to finish.